Dear colleagues, good day to everyone. We bring to your attention the media statements of the prime ministers of the associated trio. Prime Minister of Ukraine, Denis Shmyhal, Prime Minister of Georgia, Irakli Garibashvili, Prime Minister of Moldova, Natalia Gavrilitsa, following the meeting with the leaders of the European Union. Prime Minister of Ukraine.
Dear colleagues, it's my pleasure to have this opportunity to talk to you in person to sum up the results of our joint visit together with the Prime Ministers of Georgia and Moldova. Today was an important day for the future of the associated trio initiative. We presented our vision and exchanged views of the further development in the associated trio together with President of European Commission Ursula von der Leyen, President of the European Council Charles Michel, and President of the European Parliament David Sassoli. I'm grateful to EU partners for a frank and comprehensive conversation on various dimensions of cooperation within the associated trio. The associated trio initiative aims to make the Eastern Partnership stronger and more sustainable on the basis of its core principles: inclusiveness, differentiation, and more for more approach. It is important to upgrade the Eastern Partnership in a way built on the already achieved successes, but also addresses remaining vulnerabilities. The current situation in the Eastern Partnership on the eve of the upcoming summit shows the urgent need to rethink the strategic goal of this important EU initiative, straighten its geopolitical significance, and give the clear message of the European perspective for those countries who would like to go further in their relations with the EU. The trio cooperation agenda will be complementary to the Eastern Partnership instruments and will not aim at replacing the existing initiatives. It is important to receive a positive assessment of joint trio efforts during the summit. The progress in implementation of the key reforms within the association agreements is somewhat even more tangible. This should be reflected in EU approach to use relevant financial instrument and assistance program. We welcome the initiatives proposed in the economic and investment plan. Looking forward to the endorsement of the announced economic and investment plan for the EEP countries, including Ukraine. We are determined to work together with partners on implementing new relevant flagship initiatives, an approach that we should be very concrete project to deliver tangible benefits for the citizens is totally supported by Ukraine. In the framework of preparation to the 6th Eastern Partnership Summit, we have taken another powerful step in filling this format with concrete content. The EU support will desire of our three countries to stimulate and develop the sectoral cooperation with Eastern Partnership. The association trio aimed on intensifying cooperation with the EU in the areas of green and digital transition, connectivity, energy security, justice and home affairs, strategic communication and health, which should be also reflected in our joint declaration following the EAP summit. We will remember that the idea of uniting the associated countries in trio format was born in the European Parliament. I believe that our countries will continue to enjoy the support of the European Parliament in achieving the more ambitious goal we are pursuing. Euronest is a platform that could be used more effectively. The EAP parliamentary dimension should be definitely conveyed to the summit in its version of the post-2020 EAP agenda. Transport. Ukraine, Moldova and Georgia, having concluded the association agreements, have accepted ambition obligation in transport areas. We have signed the Common Aviation Area Agreement with the EU. TNT comprehensive map is extended to Ukraine, Moldova and Georgia as well. Association TRIO is already deeply integrated into the EU transport networks. At the same time, Ukraine, Georgia and Moldova are interested to negotiate with the EU in the framework of the Association TRIO on liberalization of the road transportation market with EU member states. Our trade relations with the EU are at that stage when we should no longer postpone a discussion on the conclusion of a road transportation agreement. We, as Association TRIO countries, fully keen to the implementation of priorities of the EU Sustainable and Smart Mobility Strategy and looking forward to cooperate with the EU on implementation of the further new connectivity strategy Global Gateway. In cooperation with the EU, we plan to move toward green transformation transport in the framework of the strategy and the European Green Deal. To achieve this goal by transport reorientation to high-speed rail traffic, multimodal transportation, digitalization, shifting freight transportation from road one to rail and water freight traffic, etc. Among other things, we discussed custom cooperation within the TRIO. We can cooperate on the implementation of the provisions of the Union Custom Code and alternative rules of origin pan-euro met. Given the high importance of the energy security issues, we stand ready to achieve engagement with the EU and the TRIO regarding the whole range of issues related to the strengthening the energy security in Europe. In that respect, we should not forget that all TRIO countries are contracting parties of to the energy community. In that respect, we could consider launching a targeted TRIO platform on energy resilience and sustainability to help manage the issues of energy security and security of supply at the regional level, as well as issues of common interest with regard to green energy transition and decarbonization related challenges. Dear colleagues, we must supplement our Eastern partnership with new possibilities. The Associated TRIO expects that the EEP summit should provide so much required political and strategic impetus for the EEP and endorse long-term objectives of the initiatives, as well as reflect the interests of all participants, the Eastern Partnership, the EU, and its member states. Thank you so much for your attention. Thank you.
The main message that we carried during our visit is the reaffirmation of TRIO's intention to further advance the integration of our countries with the European Union, to take stock of already achieved results, and to identify together with the leaders of the EU institutions the next steps towards more sectoral integration.
The presence of three prime ministers in Brussels only 2 weeks ahead of the Eastern Partnership Summit is no coincidence. We are here to take stock of how far we've come and plan for our common way forward. Our destination is clear. The road to the Eastern Partnership Summit should stay true to producing a strong and forward-looking political declaration. As TRIO, we can only succeed with the support of the EU. We thus continue to advocate for stronger EU engagement in our region.
Thank you.
Yeah, Mr. Mayor, thank you.